Oranjemund, established in 1936, from which point onward CDM, now Namdeb Diamond Corporation, provided every service, the schooling, infrastructure and entertainment required for the people of the town, mostly employees of the mine. In the 1990s, this gradually disappeared as Namdeb Diamond Corporation outsourced many of the town's services and scaled back their role in Oranjemund. Oranjemund was a closed town governed by Namdeb. How has this changed over the years and what are the major differences between now and 30 years ago?
Oranjemund was originally established simply as an accessory works to the mine in 1936. And obviously, over time, it developed not really as a town, but as simply as the necessary infrastructure to provide services to the employees, housing to the employees, and then the necessary services for people to be able to live comfortably at the mine. And as such, it doesn't have the infrastructure that the normal town has. The water distribution, electricity, and everything is just distributed to all the houses without metering or any ability to sell that to the individual residents.
Remember now, for the last 81 years, the diamond mining activities was the center piece around which everything in Oranjemund pivoted. And with the life of mine officially up to 2022, it's quite evident that we have to find alternatives unless we want to end up like Coleman's Kop or any of the other ghost towns. I think for everyone who's been in Oranjemund, we consciously made a decision that that is not going to be the end state of Oranjemund, and hence why an organization like OMDis has been created to start with a journey of economic diversification.
So obviously, when this journey started to transform Oranjemund to a normal town, a lot of work had to be done. And that's why this process actually took a very, very long time. The initial thoughts around proclamation of the town already started in the late 90s. And as you know, it was only proclaimed as a town in 2012. Mm-hmm. That is why, because there was a lot of research and work that had to be done to understand how one would take something that's actually accessory works and make it a normal operating town.
I will start by explaining what transformations are before qualifying how that works in the context of a town. So transformations are where you actually organize deliberate programs that achieve a environment where you've got a current state which is at risk to create a future state that can sustain and survive. So in the context of town transformations, what you typically have is you have a town that is at risk because of economic decline, because of social unrest, or whatever that risk may pose. And then you implement a deliberate program to achieve an altered state that ensures that town's future. I was fortunate in my prior career to work in financial services where I led continental strategies, but distinguished myself not in terms of just what is required and why, but how you actually achieve that. And therefore, Oranjemund, when they were faced with quite a complex situation of where you've got a potential flailing mine on which the town is entirely dependent, how do you actually create that altered state? Not just creating a vision and creating hope, but walking with the town that path of how to make the interconnected components achieve that end state. So let's start looking at it from the most simplest and kind of, let's say, from the more emotive perspective is you first want to do town transformations to create a future for people that have lived there and loved an environment and want to make sure that they've got a future and a reason to continue to live there. So you want to create a future for their community. If you want to look at it from a very different perspective and a little bit more broader outline is from a country like Namibia that at the moment, and I think it's not been true in the past, want to create economic stability and not actually create a risk or environment that actually requires a social risk or could become a social risk. So from that perspective, want to make sure that you create in every aspect of your country, wherever the opportunity presents itself, the opportunity for economic stability. And then if I want to add a third lens to that is also we've kind of understood that over years, a lot of infrastructure investment has happened in that town. So another reason for transforming it is to make sure that those assets that exist are leveraged for the best of a future and actually not go to waste. So you need to look at it from a human perspective, an asset perspective, but also from a broader economy perspective and a regional and or national perspective. How do you create value and not let that value that's been created over so many years go to waste?
and all those levels play together.
Exactly, exactly, all intersect. I will start from a top-down perspective and break it down in largely three broad stakeholder groups. And it's really quite important because I think, especially in transformations and town transformations, these stakeholders are really, or the ability of how they interact, or the quality in terms of how they interact is what really secure your future. So on the one hand, you've got your public sector, and I'll come back to that. Then on the other hand, your private sector, and then quite importantly, what's quite often overlooked in these contexts is your civil society. So from a public sector perspective, your stakeholders are, of course, your national government. They are required to make sure that there's sufficient support from a national perspective to make sure that the transformation can happen. And that might be that they pass certain regulations or provide certain incentives that allow that environment to actually transform. Coming a little bit closer to home on a regional level and on a local level, of course, that is also the role of the government, is to make sure that there are sustainable services, affordable services, and that there are also incentive structures that creates the environment in which economic transformation can happen. Mm-hmm. Then, a little bit kind of on the private sector side, and in particular in the case of Oranjemund, mm-hmm. you immediately have your private sector in the context of Namdeb, mm-hmm. that have been then operates as the mine to play an active role to accelerate this transformation process in the environment that they've led for so long.
So obviously Namdeb has been key in establishing the town of Oranjemund. And the future of the town, I think, to a large extent, is also dependent on the actions that Namdeb takes. And part of that has been the establishment, the OMDis Town Transfer Agency. It is a Section 21 company created by Namdeb. As you said earlier, I'm the chairman of that board. And this company really has only one objective, and that is the economic transformation of the town. Now, typically mining towns are completely dependent on the mines where they are situated. And as a result, most mining towns, once the mining stops, and mining is finite, we have to all realize it. Mm-hmm. At some stage, mining runs mm-hmm. out. Mm-hmm. And because it's finite, a lot of towns actually fail economically when the mines eventually run out. Mm. And what we decided is that we really do not want to see that in Oranjemund. It's a unique town. Mm. People have lived there for decades and generations.
Yeah.
And it's so important for us, the facilities that are there, the strategic location of Oranjemund, the importance in the economy, that this town actually has a long and prosperous future. So Namdeb is playing an enabling role and has played an enabling role in creating OMDis. Mm. And the role of OMDis is to take Oranjemund or to facilitate the economic diversification of Oranjemund, to establish other industries, and there's huge opportunities. As I said earlier, strategically located, and there are a lot of other opportunities that comes with the facilities that are there, access to the national park, fantastic road infrastructure. But these things don't happen organically. Mm. And Namdeb's role in the town is now to enable this economic transformation.
But if you look beyond Namdeb and start looking into the future of the role of the private sector, is where you have to look at investors locally and on a national basis. How do they play an active role by being proactive in supporting a transformation process by investing in the town? So, and then of course, obviously it goes without saying, is business makers. So people that actually kind of do want to create entrepreneurial activities there. You do need those people in a transformation process to actually be a lot more active than what they might have been to ensure organic processing takes over once you've kind of get over a tipping point of a deliberate transformation program of work. And then lastly but not least, and it's again very particular in mining towns and in Oranjemund's case, is civil society. You have an environment where that stakeholder group has been to a great extent dependent on the mine. A little bit to your introduction of just how much the mine provided for them, and therefore they didn't really have to forge and be responsible for their own futures because it was created for them by a mine. So now, in addition to economic activities with them, you have to actually do social behavioral changes to shift the norms of that stakeholder group to make sure that a level of agency and self-responsibility develops so that they invest in their time, they take ownership for the environment, they take ownership in making sure that the economy flows. So those are really your broad stakeholder groups in a nutshell that really have to work and intersect to make transformations successful, which is why it's not so straightforward.
There's the public sector, which is sort of the national and local government, the private sector, which in Oranjemund features Namdeb, it features OMDis, other businesses in the town, and then we're the third leg. We are the community or the citizenry leg in that process. And our role is really to encourage our community to become really, truly active in determining the future for Oranjemund. And it's not an easy process for them to go and to undergo, because we have to remember, as you said in the introduction, the people that live in Oranjemund have been totally dependent on Namdeb Diamond Mine. And Namdeb made all their decisions for them in the town. They had no say in what happened. They got lots of advantages over other town. They got free services, they got free water, electricity, and so on. But they had no stake before in the future of what was going to happen. So they were totally dependent on what the mine said. So our major role is to try and help remove this dependency culture. So we're looking for mindset change, and with that mindset change, we're hoping to influence the community so that we have positive behavioural changes, and so that we can, every one of us in the town, can take responsibility for where the town is going to be. And that's really our key role in the process.
And also that ownership.
Absolutely, so, so important. You can't go anywhere without ownership.
So today, where we stand today, the infrastructure has already been transferred to the Oranjemund Town Council, and the council is responsible for the normal, all the municipal services, including water supply. All the metering systems have been installed in order to build the residence, and as we speak now, the electricity has been transferred also to the town council, and the normal billing now starts.
The people need now to adapt to certain bylaws which were passed by council, certain policies and procedures which were not in place. And I think the big difference is that the community now need to take responsibility and pay for their municipal services, which were free all the years. And that was quite a major shift, because we as a council also had the duty to transform the town into a normal town.
Absolutely.
That's what it is.
So it's actually been quite a journey to just get the transfer of the town. So it is actually now has become a normal operating town. And that journey is one where we see a number of phases. And there's been a lot of research done on this. And the first phase is called transfer. And that's about complete where we stand today. Transfer is just making Oranjemund a normal open town. The next phase is called transition. And that is all about making sure that people actually take ownership of their town. It has been a town where up to now Namdeb has provided all the services, have been doing everything, and where people haven't really played a role in owning and their town and being proud of it. So that transition part is where your public services, your schools, your hospital, clinic, becomes part of the normal way of how a town operates, and where the citizens of the town take ownership.
We want to transform the town into an economically sustainable town, a diverse town, a culturally diverse town, where everybody has an input into what the future may be. And so only 2030, the vision was formed. And the reason it was 2030 is that previous transformation studies all around the world have shown that it takes approximately 15 years to transform a town. So it started as a vision, but then it took two more years till 2017 before that vision became a reality. And in the meantime, the public and private stakeholders and the citizenry were trying to work out exactly what this, where this process should go. And originally then, OMD 2030, the programme of work, was formed to assist the actual transformation process. So it was a way to deliver town transformation. And the actual programme was governed by a steering committee of the stakeholders in town. And the problem with that was that we had public stakeholders and private stakeholders that already had their own interest in town, and they were also governing this programme. So there was no real space for citizens to have their voice and to actually be part of the process. Yes, they can be part of the programme, but to actually drive the process as well, there wasn't room for citizens. So then this programme of work gradually evolved into what OMD 2030 is today, that, you know, something I'm very, very proud of that's happened, and that is we are now a totally independent community organisation, and we're one of the key role players in the transformation journey, and we now have a voice for what is happening.
Could you shed some light on those opportunities and possibilities as to how the town can change and grow?
If you look at Oranjemund, unlike many of the towns in Namibia and in elsewhere in the world, we've got lots of physical endowment. We've got the mighty Orange River that comes from the center of Africa, basically coming to our shores in Oranjemund. We've also got a shoreline in Oranjemund in the Spergebied area that stretches 270-300 kilometers. And then we've also got the sand. That's the physical endowment, but more importantly, what Oranjemund offers, we've got a strong diamond history. And that was the initial reason for existence. And diamonds has made Oranjemund what it is today, and diamonds has also made a lot of contribution to the fiscus of the Namibian state. Diamonds has also made a lot of contributions in my private life as well. So those are the opportunities. And also further, I mean, as part of the OMDis program, we're looking at what is our competitive advantage. And our competitive advantage would include, amongst others, the Orange River. We've got water, we've got arable land. And so a logical area of focus for distinction in for Oranjemund would be agriculture. So we're looking at desert agriculture. We've already started a pilot project in 2015 and has shown significant and positive good progress. And we're now in a stage where we want to commercialize, you know, exports. So food security is a quite an important focus area for OMDis, and Oranjemund residents and others can actually become part, other investors can become part of this great opportunity. Then apart from that, tourism, we're sitting on the doorstep of the Spergebied area. There's potential concessions that will become available for Oranjemund people, other Namibians and foreign investors. And that we believe that basically those two industries, agriculture and tourism, can play a significant role in the re-engineering, the new Oranjemund of 2030.
Oranjemund further can be developed into a student town. Mm-hmm. It can become an education hub, just like Stellenbosch many years back.
Yes.
So we can draw students from all over the country, and as far as Northern Cape, Western Cape, and so forth.
Absolutely.
So there's a lot of potential.
Yes.
And there's a lot of very good governance policies in place.
I think we are uniquely positioned right now, Namdeb as well as the town, to write a different story. Many mining companies, once they pull out of communities, then leave legacies where people are suffering economically and so forth. And in this case, I do think we've got a completely different opportunity.
Absolutely.
We want to show also the good that diamonds does. Diamonds have played, and diamond mining here in Namibia has played such an absolute key role in our economy. It's played a key role in developing communities, developing careers. And we want to continue that legacy. And that is really the ambition that Namdeb has in this. We want to have a positive legacy where people can look back in decades to come and say that is the role that diamonds played in our lives, in our community, has been great, and it's been building the future that that we want to see for our country and for obviously for the town of Oranjemund going forward.
My hope is that Oranjemund will develop and grow to become a self-sustainable town, not dependent on one commodity, which are diamonds.
Absolutely.
And I hope that the management of this town will manage the town in such a mature manner that it will grow as one of the flagship towns within Namibia. And I hope that Oranjemund will be developed not to become a ghost town, but that all stakeholders will take hands. I urge them, in fact, to take hands and develop our beautiful desert town to a self-sustainable town.
We believe diamonds make life brilliant. And as Namdeb, we want to live up to that.
For more information, visit www.omdis.co.